But this semester, I'm really trying to integrate a lot of the resources that students already have that have been given to them by the school into the classroom. So I'm trying to encourage them to use their iPads and their MacBooks and their pencils every day in class. I'm moving them out of the traditional lecture space where they come and they listen to me talk for 75 minutes and they, you know, scramble to try and write down everything I'm saying by breaking it up, introducing these new aspects to class. They do a lot of group work, which is what's going on today. So I provide them either notes or sort of a guided worksheet through Canvas, and then they can download it and they work on it in their groups on their own time. That allows me to kind of talk to the students individually, get a better sense of where they're at.
I think the group work is like helpful as far as like it gets you to interact and kind of put it to practice what you're learning, and being able to have the iPad, the ease of that, it just makes it all kind of easy and interactive.
We're also using the Notability, the integration with Google Docs. A lot of times they'll do activities in class that I then want to see and apply some sort of grade to, so they can actually just handwrite whatever their answers are and then they can upload them to Google Drive and those come straight to me. And so I'm not collecting papers and I'm not trying to organize things, but I can go through, write my comments on them, and then share them right back with the students.
I like to handwrite my notes, so I hate having papers and like different notebooks, like carrying all that stuff around, so I like just having my one iPad on me.
All of my students can download copies of my notes that I make before class, and then they can kind of fill them in as I'm going. So they're not writing down examples and definitions, but really using the space for practice problems and to write down anything extra that they need. I also write my notes directly on the same copy that they were given, using my iPad and then the AirPlay that's connected to the projector in the room. And at the end of the class, I'll upload those notes as well. So they not only have copies of my notes before I filled in the answers and filled in all of the examples, but they also have a completed copy.
Dr. Sutherland actually uses, like, she uses skeletal notes, and like she has a bunch of stuff pre-filled in. And so the first day of class, I wasn't using it for notes because I hadn't gotten it together yet. And so I was falling pretty far behind because she already had the skeletal notes filled in, so I couldn't fill it in and then add what she was adding as well. But with the app that I'm using and the Apple Pencil on the iPad, I can download the skeletal notes and then fill it in as she's filling it in, so I can keep up faster. And so I'm not falling behind and understanding things better because I'm with her on it.
The pencil versus a just generic stylus has really improved the way I can easily write on a PDF. I don't have to zoom in real close and be careful with writing. It's as natural as writing with a pencil or as writing with a dry erase marker on the board, except they're permanent notes and that I can share immediately with the students. The precision and the options that come with it, especially combining it with an app like Notability, has really improved the app for me. Before I had the pencil, I was using a generic stylus, and you know, the app does have nice features that allow you to zoom in on a part so you can write large so that you can get the letters right. But now with the pencil, since it's just like writing with, you know, an ink pen, I don't really have to do that. It looks just like my handwriting does, which I've never been able to achieve using an iPad and a stylus.
Compared to the pencil I have, I know mine lags a lot and it disconnects and then connects and then disconnects, and it's really annoying. And when I've used the Apple Pencil, it's a lot more fluid and a lot easier to write with.
So I would encourage the digital note-taking just because it really does simplify things for me and for the students. Sharing my notes with my students immediately and allowing them to just add to them and embellish them in their own way skips the time wasting of just copying each other's notes and skips straight to the application and trying out the new concepts and figuring out things on their own.